Hello, one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play Planet Explorers with me, Ecky Thump. We're back here at the colony on Maria. You'll recall last time round we went and retrieved this Mr. Malik fellow from the very north shore of the continent. He was way, way, way up here, up there at the Malik camp. We brought him back and he has the design we need for the ship we need to get to the North Continent, which is apparently what we need. So let's he did give us a task last time. Put the McTalk support somewhere in the colony, and I can think of no better place than right here. So let's see, McTalk support. Exactly how we do that, I'm not sure. Let's see, have I got the right thing here? McTalk support frame. Ah, it's probably something I have to build, isn't it? It needs aluminium alloy and steel. Okay, so let's have a look then. McTalk support, we need 50 aluminium alloy, which means we need to make 41 more. So we need like 6 of these. And 48 of those. Very good. Then we're going to need some steel. Let's make 60 steel, which gives us all the materials we need to make the McTalk support. So let's put that in the replicator. And I think while that's whizzing away, I'm actually going to get a bit of sleep, because I am, every episode I seem to start off at zero comfort. Who knows why? Get rid of this. Shit, we don't need that. McTalk support. One of. Here we go. Okay, I've acquired a McTalk support. That didn't take very long. I'm still going to get a bit of sleep though. Where's my bedroll? Here it is. Good morning, one and all. Right, get that. Let's go outside and whack down the McTalk support. Then we'll see what's next. McTalk support, here we go. Oh my lord. Oh, there's just about space for it. There. Okay, well that's it is blocking off the particle cannons. Maybe we should put it somewhere else. I wonder if I can pick it up. No, I can't. Never mind, we don't need this side of the base defended. Well, we've got a little bit of defense anyway. Should have planned this out in advance. Never mind. It's all a process. So, where's Malik? Somewhere off to the south at the moment. So let's go and find out what the next stage is. Percy.
What is it?
I've set up the support structure.
That. Very nice. I'm going to start connecting and interfacing all the control systems on this baby. We've also finished up the airframe script. You can start replicating that. This script requires some computational metamaterials. You might want to talk to Kanar about that. He's one of the foremost experts on that stuff. He came with us on our lifeboat.
Computational metamaterials. Can you make them out of wood? Because we've got lots of that lying around. I don't know. Cuda. All right, we've got to talk to Cuda. I noticed someone called Luminaire, who I assume is also one of Malik's lot. He's over here now. He's got a quest for us. Luminaire Zeal. Who are you again? I'm Luminaire. I belong to the education department of this mission. What do you teach? Literature, math, and social studies. We had 10 teachers on this mission. I hope they're all okay. In the meantime, we have a couple of kids here. It would be great if we could have a classroom set up for them. Yeah, well, we're not going to be here very long. I guess we can set one up on the McTalk. Why did you come on this mission? I love teaching. When I saw the colonist recruitment news, I thought all about all the children going on the mission. They'll need teachers. To be sure, it didn't have to be me, but I wanted to be part of bringing human history and literature to another planet. The generations growing up later will be directly influenced by how well I teach, and that's an opportunity that I couldn't pass up on. She's very confident in her own abilities. She's going to be the founder of education on Maria. Have you seen Kuna around? I can't find him anywhere. Yeah, he was heading to the Pajo ruins in the northern desert with Jane and Andre. He wanted to do some research into the material composition of the alien ruins. They left a while ago. If you want to go check up on how they're doing, let me mark the area on your map. Ah, I knew it was too easy. Alright, quest for metamaterials, probably. There's probably an NLS on the end of that, I just can't see it. In the northern desert, you say? All the way over there, okay. I would imagine, did we charge the helicopter last mission? After the end of last mission? No, we didn't, it's almost empty. Okay, well I'm going to stick that on charge. And what I'm going to do in the meantime is go to the meteorite crater and get some copper for the other half of what's-his-name's quest. The Pooja ambassador is upstairs. Someone's still grooving out. Right. That's definitely got to go in there. Batteries. I've got a couple of spares on me. They'll probably be alright. Okay, let's go and have a bit of a mine. There we go. 1,700 units of copper. Let's see if Ambassador Vblos appreciates this wondrous gift. Let's go up the quick way. Wait a minute, where is he? Vblos! Vblos! Where are you? Maybe he's gone down for lunch. Ah, there he is. Yeah, he's just sitting in the wall, having a sandwich. Here are the resources that you've requested. This will ensure that our relations will raise to a new level. Fantastic. Don't know what that means. I'm sure it's a good thing. Let's get our helicopter back. Only at 61% still, wow. Okay, what script did we get? Here we are, the McTalk frame script. What do we need to make this? We need a computational metamaterial and a whole bunch more aluminium alloy. Jesus, we're going to need more aluminium at this rate. Oh, and we're going to need that copper we just gave to the ambassador. Never mind, we can get some more of that. In fact, let's go and get some more of that while we wait for the chopper to charge. Should have checked that. I didn't even think before I left the mine. I think actually while I'm doing this, what I might do is... Oh god, I keep forgetting where you actually go to... processor, isn't it? VIP colonists. Oh, they're all busy anyway. I was going to say, what I might do is tag on. Everyone's busy collecting plants and stuff. Let's actually go into process two and ask them to dig up a bunch of aluminium for us. And hopefully, like when, like in 5 seconds, when whoever's doing this one that finishes, they'll switch to process two. Or not. No, they've got something else they want to do. That's fine, I guess. I just wanted someone to go and collect some aluminium while I was busy with the copper in case it ran out, but okay. Right, where do we stand now? 336. I'm thinking that should be enough. Oh, we're not going to run out of aluminium, it's fine. Right, so we needed, let's just double check. McTorque frame needed 100 aluminium alloy, which is going to need a... I'm just going to make 14 of these. I don't think we'll need that many. In a bit, we're going to have to get some sand as well. We're nearly out of that. Bet there's going to be more to this. Right, we can make 112 alloy. That's fine. We need some more steel. And then we just need to have a quick jaunt out to the desert, pick up some computational metal materials. Bish bosh, job done. I will switch these batteries over. I've just noticed the one I've got equipped is virtually empty. Yeah, 8%. I could do with a bit of juice. Right, come on ladies, we're going back to the desert. We enjoyed it so much the first time round. We've still got all the crappy choppers on us anyway. We didn't put those back down, we're carrying the entire Air Force in our backpack. Right, let's go and find this, what was he called? Quiro? Quirda? Something like that. It can't have been called Quiro, but it was close. This doesn't look like a wise place to be exploring, considering that this is actually technically still an inhabited city, and the guys here don't like us very much. Alright, let's see. Andre Barros, you don't look well at all. What's wrong with you, mate? You look very down in the dumps.
What's up?
Oh, it sounds alright. Are you okay?
Am I seeing things? We both die or what?
No. What happened to you?
Where are the others? There were two other people with me.
Settle down, mate. Settle down. What happened? And what the fuck is that thing over there?
We were doing some research around this building, and then I got knocked out. It was the big local aliens.
Sorry, mate, I was distracted by that bipedal elephant over there. You were saying something about local aliens? The Paja?
Is that what you called them? I didn't really put too much of a fight. One of them just threw me to the ground. Then I ragdolled.
Do you have any idea where they went? We need to go find them. Something about metamaterials.
Whoa! What happened to you? You sound like a mature chap now.
Why, thank you.
I don't know where they went, but there was this Paga camp to the southeast that we avoided. Maybe they're taken there.
It's Paja.
Right. Let me mark it on your map. Help me up, will ya? I'm coming along.
Oh, great. I'm sure you'll be a big help. Is any of this goat leaf, possibly? No, that's dragon pod. Oh well. How far away is it? Oh, we're walking. Sorry, it's within radio distance. Jesus, this fucking planet. Look at that. Just when you think you've seen it all. It's not even just a bipedal elephant. It's a bipedal elephant with a fucking dolphin's tail. And like four vestigial arms that serve no possible purpose whatsoever. At least it's not hostile. Oh, goddammit. I thought I saw some shit then. It was just another dragon pod. Oh, this camp here. Yeah, we didn't need to fly here, did we? Is it this camp? It's somewhere around here.
I don't want you to have a bad opinion of my combat skills. I'm quite deadly. I just wasn't prepared last time.
Sure. Yeah, okay, I believe you. Maybe this is goat leaf. No, it's Dana Fern. I mean, goat leaf sounds like it should be something that's up in the mountains somewhere.
You found our camp. That's good, but it's hard to believe what's happened to you guys so far. The Martian colony, the battles with the Puga, the peace treaty. Compared to you, we've been drinking martinis and watching the locals fighting it out on the plains.
So the Puja and Parja never showed you any threat?
Not until now, no. That's why we were waltzing around here without a care in the world. Really foolish in hindsight.
Look at this idiot. What does he think he's doing? Oh dear. Okay, well, maybe he's got some really awesome moves in combat. He could do, you never know, you can't judge a book by its cover. Right, what are these weird cacti? They are flowering cacti. Might have guessed. Oh, wait a minute, is this where we're supposed to be?
Where did they go? No one's here.
You noticed then? Jane Austen, really? For fuck's sake. Okay, Jane Austen screams, help! Did you hear that?
Yeah, it's from over there. Come on.
Hold on, Jane Austen, we're coming. Sweet Mother of Jesus.
What the hell?
The fuck is that? Sky people, there are more, get them! Oh crap! Take out the bear thing, that sounds like a very good idea! Hold on, wait a second! I need 1 second, I've got to deploy our secret weapon, Golem Buddy! Sick 'em, boy! Oh, they've got the bear thing down already, that's good. Yeah, Golem Buddy's doing work. Maybe we should get that guy with the bazooka on the far side. Ah, don't fall in the fucking pit, whatever you do, Jesus Christ. That's it, Golem Buddy. We're doing it. We gotta save Jane Austen and the guy who's actually important to the quest. Go on, lads, punch him. Punch him to death. That's it. Okay. Well, we did it. This looks very much like a gladiator arena to me. This would appear to be a clear breach of the human Paja, don't fuck with us, we won't fuck with you treaty of 2 episodes ago. There shall be a serious diplomatic incident about this.
Huh?
I'm glad that bear didn't shoot fire.
There are bears in this planet that shoot fire? What kind of rock did we land on? And I thought the Pada were already strange enough.
Oh, mate, you have got no fucking idea. What made you come on this mission, anyway?
I didn't tell you this before. I was extremely bored of my desk job back in the system, doing paperwork for freighter entering and leaving lunar orbit. So, when the civil officer job opened up, I just had to get it. The pay's also really good. In 15 years, I could go back to Luna a rich man. At least that was the plan. I think it's out the window now.
You never know. You never know. Chin up. What will you do now? We have enough room for you in the colony now. Come on. No, don't run off, Kuna. No, don't run off, Kuna. Oh, okay. Let's get back to base first, then. I guess you're all coming back, are you? Including... Oh, shit. Fat Ginger Jane Austen. Actually, she's probably not that fat. She's just wearing a massive bulletproof vest. Right. Back in the pack, Golem buddy. I think we're just going to fast travel back to the colony again. 204 meat books. Okay. Where's our man? It's getting a bit crowded in here. I guess he's upstairs. Yeah, checking out his new digs. So it's Kuna. What happened? We were doing some material research at the alien ruins when these brutes showed up and captured us. I'm not sure what happened to Andre, but the aliens dragged Jane and I to this bear pit and tossed us in for entertainment. Before you guys showed up, I was starting to see my life flash before my eyes. Haha. For entertainment? Yeah, I thought they'd at least try to talk to us, unfamiliar beings and all. But no, no communication, and into the bear pit we go. They seemed to know who we were, though. We didn't have that translator you've got, that's pretty handy. Why'd you come on this mission? Well, where I'm from, it's super crowded, and the pollution's pretty bad. So I thought, what the heck? I want to go out and see the universe, breathe some fresh air while I'm at it. Although, if I'd known we'd be in a situation like this, I'd probably stick with drinking my polluted water. Let's check your shop, double quick. Bunch of stuff we've already got, mostly. Type S jetpack. I wonder if that's better than the one I've got, anyway. Percy needs your help. Computational metamaterials. Oh yeah, I have several written... I've written several scripts for that. Let me give you the best fit. Suits you, sir. Okay, sweet. There we go. Computational metamaterials script. We don't want to give you any more resources for Ploas. We want to use the resources of this planet for ourselves. Okay, into the power plant with the copter. Gonna remember to do so this time. Copter. Into the plant. I really wish, in hindsight, I'd waited long enough to get the full version of that helicopter with the special ultra fuel cell. Just so that it'd last for a there and back journey, you know. Right, stop making whatever the fuck is this you're making, like grain or flour or whatever. Oh, now, do we have to manufacture the... Fine. Okay, you start on your grain. I've got to check if I need to make these metamaterials first. Yeah, I do. It's a script. Okay, what do we need for those then? Computational meta. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. What? Okay, we've got some resource gathering to do, possibly. Ah, oh, dear. Okay, so we need 600 water to start with. We need a bunch of extra battery packs. We need copper, we need zinc, we need copper wire. Okay, let's take this one at a time. Let's head down to the shore. We'll get some water. We'll pick up some more petroleum and sand while we're there, because we need it for that aluminium alloy. Okay, where's me water sucking device that I've used once before previously? Fertilizer sprayer, parachute, mobile water pump, there we go. I think that's the one. Let's suck. Okay, that's enough water. That's more than enough water, in fact. Let's get some more sand and petroleum. I don't think we need to specifically get sand. It just happens to turn up in our inventory while we're digging these tar sands out. Okay, whatever. That'll do for now. 1,322 plutonium. Petroleum, even. Alright, let's take a look at what else we need to make this hydrogen, first of all. We need 600 of that, which means we need a bunch of these, which means we need silver. Now, silver we don't have back at camp, I'm pretty sure. There is some silver somewhere there. Copper, iron, AG, which is silver, and coal, so we can get that at base. We are almost out of zinc. But we only need one zinc per battery, and we only need six batteries. So 20, whatever it was, 23 zinc, I think we had. That should last us. I mean, unless we need, at some point, a shit ton more batteries. So we should be alright if we just head back to base and find our way down to the wherever the silver is at that mine. I can't remember ever actually seen any, honestly. But I have marked that it's there, and I do trust past Eki. Oh, hold the fucking phone. Okay. Let's see how big a deposit this is. Three. Oh, shit. That means potentially we only need to find one more poop. And that pointless quest that we've had lying around for ages will be in the bag. Let's keep a very close eye out on the way back to base, just in case. And let's try not to get wrecked by a lupus hare because we're driving so slowly. All these wolves. Yeah, in fact, let's speed past the wolves. Okay, so I've marked on the map that somewhere around here is some silver. So let's see exactly where. It's way the fuck down. We only want a tiny bit of it as well. Which way am I facing? Facing south. We could honestly just start digging down. I think we want to try and hit the highest part of the silver node, which is like here. But we've got to do a fair bit of digging. Let me just mark this spot. Maybe we want to... it's about there. Maybe we want to try that drill out. I remember ages ago we got this script for this drill. It's a little bit of an investment of steel and a couple of other things. Okay, so no, we need two of those. I'm spending resources, this is going to come back and bite me in the arse, but... I mean, it's worth it. Well, we haven't played with the drill yet, so let's just try it out and see how it goes. Okay, one drill. Let's give this a whirl, see how it goes. Let's put it in slot 7, why not? Well, hello, not bad. And it does gather resources. Well, it gathers dirt anyway. Let's not plan this at all. Let's just dig. Okay. We'll worry about how we're going to get out afterwards. Right, so we want to go this way a little bit. Not this way, north. This way? Yeah, this way. We still need to go down a little bit. We should be around about the right area. Let's have a zoom in close and see how we're doing. Okay. So pretty much if we dig north from here, we should start running into the upper edge of the silver vein. Is that it? No, that's just some rock. This is something, I think it's coal. Let's start digging here anyway. Oh no, it's silver. It's kind of hard to make the silver out against the stone. This is probably true to life, but it just seems to be slightly larger rocks. Okay, let's see if we can make ourselves a slightly more convenient exit. Okay. Right, we'll never remember where that is. In fact, maybe we should mark it. Let's just put a an S here. There we go. So we know that that's the entrance to the Silver Shaft. So, anyway, we were working on computational metamaterials for which we needed hydrogen, for which we needed some more batteries, for which we need more plastic. And 30 wire, does that sound right? Something like that. So, oh no, what else do we need? Shit, no, we don't have nearly enough zinc. God damn it. Okay, let's make the ones we can make. That's an extra 2. Let's pick up the car which we've left lying around. Let's see. They do like to occasionally make batteries if they're not in storage, and I think I stole the ones that were actually there. Worst comes to worst, what I can do is just nick the spare ones out of the ladies' backpacks. Maybe they've even got some zinc in storage, you never know. Right, let's have a look in the toy box then. 2 spare batteries, good. That's 4. No zinc. They've literally only gathered what they needed. We have 100 hydrogen here, so we only need one more. Which means, Medea, I'm going to take yours. No, I'm going to take your full one. And then at some point they're going to realise there's no batteries in storage. And they're going to produce some more. Right, so that should be enough to make the hydrogen. So that's the hydrogen. Now we need 54 aluminium alloy. Wait a minute, only 54. So, oh god, okay, it's about 8 of these, I think. Pretty much perfect. Right, that's the alloy and the hydrogen. Now we need 4 of these. Fuck's sake. Okay, let's just restock on some plastic. There's a miniature war going on outside. What is taking so long out there? What are you being attacked by? If I come out there and find a fucking lupus here, I'm going to be very upset. Okay, it was one of these. That's a bit better then. You're forgiven. Provisionally. Okay, that's all the materials we needed. Let's get this computational metamaterial crafted. Gonna have to cancel that order again. Meta. And there we go. Computational metamaterial. Right. Oh god, now we actually need to use that to make the frame now. There's probably a whole bunch of other shit we need to make the frame as well. Okay, alloy. We need 50 more of this. So, let's get the frame in the queue. Okay, let's let them finish building this fucking wheat or whatever it is they're building. There we go. We'll add the frame to the queue. Here we are. One McTorque frame. Okay, let's give Percy this. Is he around anywhere? He is. Somewhere off to the southeast at the moment. Right, Percy, we've finished building the Atmos skipper frame. Here, catch.
Just in time. We're just putting the finishing touches on the cabin script. Here it is. We need Anjum to make us some custom seats. Now on to the hard part. I haven't designed an engine since my early days. This will be fun indeed.
Okay, so we're going to continue work on the McTorque skipper, but we're going to do that next time. Because we're out of time and out of comfort. And very much running out of materials, although I have sent the minions to collect more, so hopefully that'll get done in the meantime. So until next time, that has been Let's Play Planet Explorers. Do hope you've enjoyed it. We did make some progress. We got these struts down. We gathered up a bunch of materials. We had a quick diversion in the alien gladiatorial bear pit. And next time we're going to get back to work on building the Atmos skipper that's going to take all of these idiots all the way across, apparently, to the northern continent. But we're going to get on with that next time. There's more building work to be done, no doubt more material farming to do. So I hope you enjoyed it. I've been Eki Thump. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game, and I will see you next time.